The 60th anniversary specials are now over. David Tennant is no longer the current Doctor, Ncuti Gatwa is. He made his first official appearance in last Saturday's episode, The Giggle, which I thought was a complete dumpster fire. Look, I haven't seen Ncuti in anything else. People in my personal life go on about how he was so amazing in Sex Education. I can't comment on that because, again, I haven't seen it, so I can only judge him and his acting capabilities based on what we saw in the third special. I didn't like his performance. It would have helped if RTD didn't make it so that he wasn't wearing any trousers, because him roaming around in his tighty-whities was so cringe and off-putting. But he didn't feel like the Doctor. He was very flamboyant and feminine, and while some people could point to the Doctor as not being a traditional masculine hero, and they would be right in some sense, Ncuti feels like the furthest away from that, and it ain't even close, so it feels like he's playing an entirely different character altogether. A big gripe I have is with his costume. The main one that they have been going with in the promotional pictures is great, but we know that he will be changing his attire in nearly every episode, and I feel that robs this Doctor of his own identity. What really made me facepalm was the first frames of the Christmas special trailer. We see the 15th Doctor prancing around in what appears to be a nightclub in this arrangement of clothes. I mean, come on. I can already tell there will be people in the comments shouting, "The Doctor has danced before, blah blah blah," but it's very obvious what they are doing. For someone who claims to hate stereotypes, Russell was doing a fantastic job of presenting those exact stereotypes on the screen. But that isn't all that is in the trailer. We get Ncuti chasing after Millie Gibson's character Ruby Sunday, who is on a ladder that is being raised into the air towards the Goblin ship. The Goblins, I believe, are the main villains of this story. I don't know what to expect from Millie Gibson. I've only seen her in Coronation Street, and there is a large difference between the two shows, so I guess she will really get her chance to shine very soon. With that being said, she seems like a sweet person, and her character reminds me very much of Rose, but I hope Russell does something else with her rather than just using the formula that he did during his first era. I have to talk about this. The new Sonic Screwdriver, in quotation marks. This thing is not a sonic screwdriver. It's maybe a sonic device, I'm fine with that, but to call it a sonic screwdriver, piss off. The memes that have spawned from this have been hilarious though. People are comparing it to the remotes from Click, a number of YouTube inappropriate products, and even a measuring spoon that you use to take in medicine, all of which are way more similar to this sonic device than the previous sonic screwdrivers in design. I'm curious to see what the sales for the toy version will be like. I can't do an in-depth analysis of the Goblin song due to copyright reasons, but I will summarise my thoughts. It sounds god-awful, their voices don't fit their appearance, it sounds like they're in a 90s pop band. I will defend this though in one particular aspect. The lyrics have the Goblins talking about eating this baby, and a lot of other anti-woke YouTubers, as we are branded, as saying that this exposes the system and their satanic rituals, etc. But I'm sorry, that is too far of a stretch. These Goblins are villains, and the lyrics reflect that. Plenty of other stories from throughout history have featured similar content. Calm down. We did get another teaser a few days ago, but there isn't much for me to talk about. We get some cool looking shots, but what is going on in them is left for the most part without context, so I would just be playing a guessing game. I will be checking out this Christmas special, probably not on Christmas Day as I feel it will ruin my Christmas, but hey, when I watch it, if I somehow find myself enjoying it, I will give it a positive review, but if I don't like it, then I will give it a negative review. I ain't a biased person like some people make me out to be, I'm just honest. Tell me what you think about this in the comment section down below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.